it's the politics of this thing. I don't trust anyone after however many seasons and all the books. Oh my god, is that...
It's Tyrion! And Cersei!
You can do this.
Oh, this is going to be awesome. Look. Oh, dear. Although everyone is watching, so if I cock this up, they will judge me for eternity.
Ah, Lady Marjorie. Aren't you looking lovely this evening?
Lord Tyrion. Your Grace? With your permission, allow me to introduce Lady Mira of House Forrester.
Hello. I will kneel before her.
Your Grace.
She liked that, yes.
The girl knows her courtesies. Impressive. You may rise.
Thank you.
House Forrester is a northern house loyal to the king.
Are they?
I beg your pardon, Your Grace.
I wasn't talking to you. I want to hear from the girl. Is your family loyal to the king?
Yes.
Perhaps you should ask the new Lord Forrester.
He's not here, is he? She is.
Joffrey is the one true king, Your Grace.
And yet, for centuries the Forresters have been loyal bannermen to House Stark. A house of traitors.
Yes.
Yes, Your Grace.
Yes. Yes, they are.
The Starks were your liege lord, yet you name them traitors so easily.
Shit.
I take it this is the kind of loyalty the king can expect from you. If you have any loyalty at all.
Shit.
Is your house willing to swear fealty to your new liege lord, Roose Bolton?
Oh!
Roose Bolton also served the Starks.
Oh shit, that might have been a bad idea.
And proved his loyalty to the crown by bringing their house to a swift and sudden end.
That was a bad idea. Oh fuck. I was trying to be clever.
Old allegiances are not easily abandoned. But now that the war is over, we must look to rebuild and forge new alliances.
Maybe that worked.
There are ships and shields to be built, and Joffrey will need a steady supply of ironwood for his armies.
Yes.
I'm told there are others who would happily serve that purpose. But I trust we can rely on House Forrester.
Forrester Ironwood does seem rather unique.
Yes, Your Grace.
Yes. Yes.
It would be a shame to see it fall into the hands of another house. I imagine you'd do almost anything to prevent that from happening.
Yes, I would.
Ask any Lannister, and they'd do whatever was necessary to save Casterly Rock. It would be unfortunate to see another house lay claim to what's yours.
Oh, God, I don't want to say yes anything. Yes anything!
I would do anything.
Oh, what a bad idea that was.
I see.
What would you have the girl do, Cersei? It's not as if she fought beside the Starks, wielding a battle axe for the Northern Army.
She's gonna make me do something horrible.
It raises an interesting question, I suppose. Can we truly blame those who end up on the wrong side of the war? Our dear Margaery here was betrothed to Renly Baratheon on the false assumption that he would one day rule the Seven Kingdoms.
Well, here we go.
Can we fault her for her mistake? Should she be held accountable?
You keep dredging this thing up, love. Oh, God.
I'm sure she regrets it.
Perhaps. Perhaps not.
Oh, shit.
If there's a point to this, I hope you find it quickly.
Loyalty can be such a hard thing to define. This city alone is filled with all sorts of ambitious opportunists looking to reinvent themselves, pretending to be something they're not. Who knows what lurks within their hearts? You are a girl from the north, here in service to Lady Margaery. One can only assume her interests are yours. Yet loyalty to a king, that must be absolute, beyond question.
Oh no.
And if your loyalties were to become conflicted between your king and the very person whom you serve, what would you do then?
Oh no.
I'm sure she would...
Let the girl answer the question. Go on.
My loyalties would never conflict, Your Grace.
That's a coward's answer. I will not have my time wasted by a northern girl who thinks she can play games.
Shit.
Who do you choose?
I was... Oh, shit. Oh, bollocks. No, fuck Joffrey.
I must choose Margaery, Your Grace.
Fuck Joffrey.
Clearly your handmaiden does not have her priorities straight.
No, I do.
She is a threat to the crown, isn't she? The most dangerous handmaiden in all of King's Landing.
My sense is this girl will say almost anything to get what she wants. Which is not very encouraging.
No, it's not. I failed at this. I thought I would, though, because Cersei's a snake.
I'd like a word with you, if I may. Of course, Your Grace.
Bollocks. I'm sorry, Margaery, I fucked up. Hi. This is rather awkward.
I'll walk you out.
Oh, thank you. It's very kind of you.
This may come as a surprise, but I met your father once at the tourney at Lannisport. Even then, he didn't trust Roose Bolton.
No one does.
We only spoke briefly, but your father struck me as an honourable man.
Thank you, Tyrion.
You have my condolences for his loss. These would be trying times for your family, even under the best of circumstances.
Thank you, Lord Tyrion. That's very kind of you to say.
He's always nice.
You were brave to declare your loyalty to Lady Margaery.
Yes, I was, and also I regret it now.
Pleased. But Cersei, she will not soon forget what you said.
Yeah, I should have faked it.
It was quite the first impression. I, of course, found it all highly entertaining. But it certainly wasn't what Cersei was expecting.
I wasn't trying to please her.
I think that was clear to everyone.
Yes.
My sister and I have our differences. She takes great pleasure in her little charades. I take mine in thwarting them. We must find our amusements where we can. She threatened to give your ironwood to another house. It is the master of coin who decides such matters.
Oh, of course.
The crown needs boats. Boats need wood, and I speak for the crown in this regard, not her.
What are you suggesting?
Nice. I forgot about that.
I suppose the crown could be persuaded to secure ironwood from House Forrester.
Oh, that's very kind of you, Lord Tyrion.
Lady Margaery might not look favorably on such an alliance, and it would infuriate Cersei. Although what would be amusing for me might prove rather dangerous for you and your house. Are you willing to risk that?
Does it mean that they... Oh!
Maybe far too dangerous.
No. Yes, I am. Yes, I am.
Did such a thing?
It's a risk I'm willing to take, Lord Tyrion. Please.
You are a brave girl, aren't you?
It might keep the family alive.
Consider it. Now, if you'll excuse me, I promised Sansa I would join her for dinner tonight. 3 beautiful bottles of Dornish wine await my arrival. The mere thought of them makes me thirsty already.
Good night, Lord Tyrion.
Good night.
Just be careful. This is not the North. King's Landing can be a nest of vipers to the uninitiated.
Yes, I've already discovered that in round one with Cersei. I thought it'd be fine. I was like, yeah, I'll just go in and I will do that. And that was right at the end. I fucked it up and I should have gone for Cersei because Margaery knew I was lying and I shouldn't have done it. I shouldn't have done it. But it's done now, innit?
Mira, I was worried. How was it?
Awful.
Cersei has a way of looking at you as though you're nothing. I'd rather not discuss it, if you don't mind.
Of course not. It must have been horrible.
I'm not telling her anything, because I think she is up to something.
Lady Margaery has spent the entire day working on seating arrangements for the wedding. Of course, you and I are seated way at the back, here with the 4th cousins and the 9th-born sons. Ah, Sir Jaime, I wouldn't mind tarnishing that white cloak of his.
Sarah?
What? It's true. And Oberyn Martell, the Red Viper.
Yeah.
I'm told he has a paramour.
You'll get us in trouble.
We're just having some fun.
Don't screw with seating plans, though, because those are very important.
We can make the right introductions. Who knows? We might meet our future husbands.
Or we might not.
Though, marrying a king, I can only imagine what that would be like.
Well, it's Joffrey, so not very nice.
Would you marry Joffrey if it meant you'd become queen? He does have a certain look about him. And he's always treated Lady Margaery well.
I don't want to be queen, no matter who I'd have to marry.
Don't want to be queen?
No, it's a horrible job.
You'd make a perfect scepter. Well, I would marry him. Imagine the power you would have as Queen of the Seven Kingdoms.
Yeah, but with great power comes great responsibility, so, you know, you'd be shit at it.
See, who else should we marry off? Brienne of Tarth and Tyrion Lannister.
No. Brienne with Jaime.
Sir Bronn and...
What are you doing?
Oh, shit. Wasn't me, it was her.
Well? Sarah?
We're sorry, my lady. We were just having fun.
I covered for you. You better be okay, Sarah.
This is not a game. It's a battle plan. Allies and enemies can be made with every move. Yet they say it is men who are powerful. The Queen was rather disappointed by your display, Mira.
Oh, fuck. Yeah, I kind of got that picture. I really screwed up.
King's Landing can be exhausting sometimes. There's always someone to please or some perceived slight to smooth over. I fear it will only get worse when I am Queen.
Once they know your true heart, the lords and ladies will have no choice but to love you.
Don't suck up to her, for God's sake.
Do you agree?
I like you. It only matters what you say, actually.
It doesn't matter what you feel. It only matters what you say.
You learn very quickly.
Yay!
Your words to Cersei were brave, but I know you must fear what the Boltons might do to your family.
Yes.
I do appreciate your willingness to appease her, as difficult as it may have been.
Thank you, my lady. There's been something on my mind. Something important.
Oh, yes. We need to talk to her about that, don't we? Now, I'm going to ask for her help. She's nice enough. She'll try and help me if she can.
I did have a favour to ask of you in return.
Whatever you wish to say, you can say it in front of Sarah. There are no secrets between us.
I bet she is. I bet she's a traitor.
It's about my family.
I trust her.
Oh, shit. No, I'm going to... No.
I prefer to speak with you alone.
Sorry, Sarah. But this is about my family, and I think you are a little bit possibly dodgy. There's certain facial features I've seen from you and reactions that maybe when you went in to see Cersei, I don't know, I'd rather not. It also, it's my family, so let's try it.
Forgive me, my lady. I wouldn't otherwise ask this of you, but my mother insisted. It's about my family.
Ramsay Snow. What would you have me do?
My mother fears our family will suffer if Ramsay is left to do as he likes. She thought, if a raven could be sent to the Boltons to let them know House Forrester has the protection of the crown. I know it's a lot to ask of you, and I wouldn't otherwise, but she insisted.
Come on, Marjorie!
That is no small request, especially now.
I know, my lady, and I wouldn't ask this of you otherwise, but my mother has left me no choice. She insisted.
Joffrey knows only too well your family fought for the Starks, and now you would have me ask him to intervene. Is the situation that dire?
It could be.
Joffrey will not look favourably on such a request.
Please, I beg of you.
Please, Lady Marjorie, I beg of you. I fear for my family's safety.
Please. I mean, it is Ramsay Snow. He will slaughter them all.
If Cersei were to find out...
Shit.
You're the only one who can help me. You have power over him, Lady Marjorie, as no one else does. Not even his mother. Ramsay Snow will arrive at Ironwrath within the week. I would never ask this of you if it weren't so urgent.
Come on. Please.
Very well.
Yeah!
But I cannot promise anything.
Thank you, my lady. I will send a raven to my family at once.
Okay, good. I'm glad we've done that, because even if it doesn't work, we have at least asked. It's probably not good. So so King's Road, Wolfswood. So we're now back with the squire. Oh my God, what is... No, 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 horse, no. Oh, shit. Well, shit.
Seven elves.
What is going on here? Oh no, I heard the words Bolton there.
No! No! No, please, no! No!
Let's play a little game, shall we?
Oh no, it's him!
Did you know my ancestors wore the skins of their enemies as a coat?
Oh shit, it's him! Oh dear God!
Not my best work, unfortunately. I suppose I have full enough practice. But he didn't make it easy, what with all that bloody noise.
Like a drowning cat. I thought he'd never stop.
As my father likes to say, a naked man holds few secrets. But the flayed man holds none.
Pity he didn't know your father was the Warden of the North.
Oh, this is really bad.
He does now. How much further is it to these foresters?
A day, my lord. Two at most.
Oh, good job.
What was that?
Good job.
My lord?
Shh. Listen.
I don't want to be hunted by him. He's a madman. If there was a definition... Oh, fuck. If there's a definition of a madman...
Hear that?
...in Game of Thrones, Bolton's.
I know I heard something.
Stay still. Shit. If you run, you're going to die. Because they'll see you and they've got crossbows.
Never mind. We've wasted enough time already.
Oh. Oh, shit. Well, I hope Ethan can deal with him. When I say Ethan, I mean me. That's the weird thing. I'm like, yeah, I hope it'll all go fine when they meet Ethan. I'm like, oh, wait a minute. That's me. I have to do that bit. Shit. Oh, no. Oh, no. What is this? This is dark and horrible and... The night is full of terrors, actually. Oh, no. Oh, dear me. Ugh.
Bloody hell.
Oh, God. That's what a flayed man is. They flay the skin from your flesh. It's gross. It's really gross. Ooh. So, I imagine that's a really short scene. Yeah, it's a really short scene because I didn't get caught. But now we're going to, I'd imagine, Ethan. Yeah.
Lord Ethan, as I was saying, you are young. And there are those within these walls who are uncertain of your leadership.
Yes.
But 300 generations of Forrester lords stand behind you.
Well, that's really comforting because they're all dead.
Lord Gerhard the Tall, who founded our house, and your grandfather, Lord Thorin the Bold, who seized back the river valley from the White Hills.
Great, no pressure.
What did they call my father?
Lord Gregor the Good.
That's really helpful.
He was fair and wise.
I want to be like him. He did seem nice. He seemed like a nice guy.
Your father was well regarded by nearly everyone. It took years, if not decades, to earn.
Oh. Oh, I've got to be a bit quicker than that.
These were your father's people to lead and protect, and now they're yours. But your father did not bear this responsibility alone. He and every Forrester Lord before him chose one man whom they trusted above all others, the Lord Sentinel. Forrester traditions demand that a new Lord Sentinel must be chosen.
I see. So you want to be it, do you?
Keep walking, you craven son of a whore. Move.
Excuse me. Excuse me.
We need his judgment.
What the hell's going on here?
I've done nothing wrong. I was only trying to survive.
What? What's happened?
Lord Ethan. Maester.
You spoke of judgment, Sir Roiland. What judgment is that?
This Craven is a deserter and a thief.
Right. Give me some context.
This house is doomed!
Oh, shit. He's one of these ones.
We all fucking know it!
Quiet, thief. Eric was supposed to be guarding our weapons, but instead we caught him stealing them.
Okay, that is a small issue.
Two shields and three spears.
Is what Sir Roiland said true?
Yes, my lord. I fled. We should all flee.
It's not stealing if you're taking what's yours by right.
He speaks truth.
I've a family to feed. And not two coins to rub together since Lord Gregor left us to rot here. Where's our pay? Our share of bread and wine grows smaller every day.
Leave the poor man alone.
Oh, shit.
Lord Ethan, I know these words are hard, but they're honest. This house is falling. We'll never survive the coming winter.
We are in this together.
You say that, but it won't be you who's starving come winter.
You'll address him as Lord.
Stop hitting him. I'm trying to have a conversation here.
Lord Ethan, you must decide the punishment. Lord Gregor always took a thief's fingers. Three of them.
Now may not be the time for harsh punishment.
I agree.
Men need to know they cannot do whatever the fuck they please. Their lord will not permit it.
They might all leave.
We can send him to the war.
Leave the man alone. Show him mercy, lord.
Oh, shit. What am I going to do?
Make him pay for what he's done.
Give us justice.
Fuck him.
I will decide.
Yeah, send him to the war.
Leave the poor man
alone. Take his fingers.
He's a thief. If you punish me, you'll be punishing an innocent man. It will be an injustice, my lord.
Right. Thanks for the guilt trip.
My lord, my family depends on me.
Justice once. Oh, shit. I'm not doing the take three fingers. Or maybe I should. No. Oh, I don't know. Oh, I don't know. Oh, this is a problem. If I show him mercy, it might go down well with the people who wanted mercy, but tell everyone that they can run amok. If I send him to the wall, that's a bit of an overreaction. Maybe. If I take three fingers... Shit. I worry now, because I know if this is the crucial point, if I fuck this up, everyone is going to see it and they're going to react. Okay. This is what my father used to do, but it's a harsh punishment. This is not what my father used to do, but it's also a harsh punishment. Oh, shit. I'm going to regret this. I'm going to regret this, aren't I? But let's try it.
Our house tends to its people. See, this man is paid and his family is fed.
Lord Ethan, you are truly a merciful and noble...
Now, if you fucking run off with some weapons, I'm going to kill you next time.
A brazen thief.
He still serves House Forrester and deserves our protection.
He's a rat in our grain stores.
Oh, dear. Well, that's gone down well, hasn't it?
We must speak about our gold reserves. Soon.
My lord, I thank you for the mercy you've shown me. I will never forget my debt to you and to this house.
You better fucking not, mate, or I'll come and hurt you. I will take three fingers on both hands. Then we'll see how you fare with a thumb and a finger.
That was certainly unpleasant, but a lord must mete out punishment when it's due.
Not just yourself, of course. It can weigh on any lord.
Maester, what do you think?
Me?
Yes. Did I do what's right?
Disloyalty shouldn't be rewarded if others will take advantage of your mercy.
Now that's what I'm worried about.
I expect this sort of thing will happen again.
Shit.
But a sentinel can help you in the face of disloyalty. You need someone you can trust by your side.
Oh, can you stop banging on about that?
Someone you can rely on, no matter the circumstance.
Let's see what he bloody says.
I think I should choose.
There are two capable men for the role.
Duncan.
They both want the job, but neither thinks very highly of the other.
How do I decide between them?
Talk to them. Solicit the opinion of people close to you. Here, the bracer of the sentinel. The badge of office. Tonight is your first small council meeting. It would be wise to bestow this bracer upon your chosen sentinel then, to show that you are decisive and in control of this house.
Right, okay. I got you.
Your sentinel will wear this for all to see.
Thank you for your counsel, Maester.
It is my duty. Come speak with me when you're ready to convene the small council, my lord.